हेलो नमस्कार सत श्री अकाल आदाब गुड मॉर्निंग गुड आफ्टरनून गुड इवनिंग व्यूअर्स फ्रॉम एनी पार्ट ऑफ द ग्लोब हु हैव जॉइंड द इलाइट क्राइम्स इलीगल इलीगल चैनल द स्ट्रीम वेयर इन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ मदर्स जर्नी हुम वी ऑल नो एंड हर फाइट वेयर इन व्हाट शी डिड स्टैंडिंग अलोन बीइंग दैट लोन वॉरियर हु रेज़ हर वॉइस अगेंस्ट द सिस्टम एंड स्टिल गोइंग स्ट्रांग. I would first like to invite my co-host for the show today, Deepti ji, on the stream. Hello, Deepti ji. Welcome to the stream. And now we go ahead and present before you Mrs. Rabia Khan ji, probably that soul warrior, that mother who against all the odds has gone solid strong and has made sure that she has always raised the voice. And despite she did not have any support, she went ahead strong, strong, strong and has always stood for herself and also for the greater good of humanity. So Deepti ji and Rabia ji, the stream is all yours. Please go ahead.
Very good day. Very, very good day, Rabia ma'am.
Yes.
How are you? How are you doing?
I'm okay. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me. And I had been watching you very closely, all your
Thank you, Rabia ji.
Yeah.
I have been trying to contact you since long, actually. Since I found those drives, which I am claiming to be Sushant's, and wherein some mention has been made about Jia Khan's murder as well. So I was trying to contact you since long. Yes, I was trying to contact you since long. And Rabia ji, I first please accept my heartfelt salutes for the 8-year fight that you have kept up for your daughter. Okay, to make the view, I want to just give a brief summary of the case of Jia Khan, who at a very young age of 25 years and who was at the threshold of a promising career in Hindi film industry, she suddenly died and it was declared as suicide. And currently, Suraj Pancholi, her then boyfriend, is on bail and is accused as the one who had abetted her suicide. I think 306 is filed on him and the case is still in the court. But here, there were many loopholes in the investigations done by the police, which like the post-mortem report which came out, it clearly showed that there were some injury marks on the body which wouldn't have come on it if it had just been a case of suicide. And also the track suit which Jia Khan wore roughly 25 minutes before her death, it is nowhere to be found. Again, shoddy investigations. As it happened in Sushant's case, the crime scene was never handled properly for the investigations. And it seems they were in a rush to declare it as suicide. Whereas there were other pointers to indicate that there has been a foul play. Because if I'm not wrong, even her phone was wiped clean. And there were no fingerprints on it, not even hers. So there were many pointers which showed that there had been a foul play, and the CCTV footage also, which has surfaced later, it clearly shows the presence of people who are closely related to someone they claim to be abetting the suicide on. So the contention here is that it is not just a case of suicide, or it is not just against Suraj Pancholi for abetment to suicide, but a lot of people who know the inner facts, including her mother, believes that this is murder. And the investigations clearly didn't happen. There was recently a BBC documentary in the month of January. Though the documentary started off well, pointing out to the faults of the police officials and the investigators, as compared to the external investigations done. I think Rabia ji herself hired some private detectives, and as she was not satisfied with the investigations done in Jia Khan case, she hired some external investigators, and they came across some facts which are till date inexplainable by the Indian authorities, which clearly point out that this is not just a case of suicide. So we will hear it out from Rabia ji herself, her journey of the past 8 years, her struggle to give her daughter the much needed justice, because she is someone, she is the right person who can know if her daughter was depressed or if her daughter has it in her to give it up like that. No one else can judge it better than the one who gave birth to her. So over to you, Rabia ma'am. Kindly please enlighten the viewers as to what exactly happened in Jia Khan's case.
First of all, I must say that I am very surprised, Deepthi, about your discovery and the findings and how you have decoded the encrypted documents that you are reading out to the audience and reaching out, because this is really a miracle. And I followed it on you on Meena Ji Show, and because somebody told me, please listen to this. So I listened and I thought to myself that how come the CBI, who has got the Supreme Court order to investigate on it, didn't get hand on it. And even then, as I heard you saying that you approached them, but you know, investigation, any doubt, any iota of suspicion, it should be taken seriously. They should have taken these pen drives and they should have looked into everything and the documents and heard you properly. But that is how they have been functioning for 9 years, what I have been discovering. It's not a very alarming or shocking news to me. Secondly, I have to say, yes, you are right, that her tracksuit is, my daughter's tracksuit was missing, and her BlackBerry that she was constantly with her boyfriend, Suresh Pancholi, she was on it, and he deleted it because he was told by his father. That's what we had heard. So beside that, what was most alarming when I read the forensic reports, that there was no fingerprints of Jia as well as mine or anybody who was there in the house, a servant or anyone, neither on the door or anywhere in the house, and not even on the fan. So, you know, fan where she was found, that's where at least her own fingerprints would have been, but there were no fingerprints. So knowing this report from the forensic who came to take the fingerprints in the house very next morning, so the police should have been alarmed. No, but police
exactly.
on that very night, because if no one's fingerprints are found,
that means someone has wiped everything clean.
Yes. So police basically came under the supervision of an officer who was not on duty but was on conversation with the accused's father, right? Was instructing the new officer who was there on duty. I will not mention names on your platform. So that particular officer was supervised. So what was he told? That just go and collect what is very crucial and wipe out everything. Because that very officer, when he came and he saw Jia, he said, this is a foul play. So if it is a foul play, right? So, a few people standing over there said, how? Says, these injuries that you can see. So the officer also saw the injury. I had already said that, look at my daughter, who has killed her. And the person, eyewitness over there, the witness who had come, she said, oh, no, please don't say who has injured her. It is a case of suicide. How did she know it's a case of suicide? Was she there? Was she there when she was doing it?
Who said this?
The witness who came, who ran to my house on my phone call, she said that, I said, dekho, who has killed my child? And look at the injuries. She immediately said, shut up, Rabia. This is not a murder. This is a suicide. And then she wiped out all whatever was on the floor. So what I'm saying, the police officer also asked her, was it that when you were trying to bring her down, that your bangle on your wrist that you're wearing, did it hurt Jia? So he said, no, I didn't even touch her there. I was holding her feet, right? So her feet at that time, when I saw, was touching the bed and below the bed. And so many injuries. And it looked like somebody has hanged her because the way the knots were tied, that way the knot was tied to the ceiling fan and the way that knot was tied around her. So it didn't look like that. And that is why I said, and my daughter will not do it. Because that very morning, when she came, she was hugging me. She booked an appointment for me. She had a meeting on following Wednesday with UTV. And we were planning, because her younger sister was coming that night. And she was planning, mommy, her birthday is coming next, next week. We've got to celebrate. So how we are going to decorate, who we are going to invite. And I've bought jewelry for her. Now, coming to the jewelry, she had 10 lakhs of rupees cash with her. She must have, got it from one of the events she attended. So that money, she was giving it to me. She said, mommy, use this money and give it to me in exchange in London, because I will be coming to London following week. So I said, okay, fine, you keep it right now. I'll take it later. I'm telling you, later that money, half of that money was given to the accused to give it to Neelu for the jury. And that is where we discovered, because see, I have discovered everything after I read the charge sheet, after I read the statements. So in the statement of accused, I read that he's saying, oh, I've given you a new order. And Jia is saying that, why are you so cold today? Now, what had happened, police who was writing the statement, because all the statements were written by police. So police who was writing the statement, that very statement changed many times. So 1 minute he's saying, I've given your new order. And then second minute, Jia is saying, why are you so cold? What happened last night, like they were dining at Marriott Hotel, and early morning, this morning, now everything changed. So suddenly everything changed. So what my question is, when CBI came to us, they asked us, did you get the new order? Did you get the jewelry? I said, no, which jewelry? Because GI had placed a new order. So my thing is that CBI knows it. I don't want to go into many details because the trial is still on. But these are many, like this, many, many things are there that I want to highlight, that why investigation has been not carried on. On who's saying, under whose pressure? So these are my my things that are hurting me, that if this is the way the police and the agency is going to investigate, then what's the point? Jo marta hai marne
do. Yes, ma'am. And also, this is a request to the viewers to kindly remember that the trial is still in the court.
Yes.
The case is still in the court, yes. So she can't go into details about the investigations as you want her to answer.
Yes.
Kindly let her feel, ma'am, kindly go ahead and tell whatever names you feel comfortable taking and what is...
I will not like to mention names, to be very frank, because, my case is on public domain. Everybody knows it. They can look. I don't have to repeat here on your platform because for various reasons. So anyway, so from the day one, I had been telling police that my daughter has been killed. We went to top police officers. We sat down. Now they are asking me, what's the proof? I said, excuse me, what proof do you have that she has committed suicide? Oh, we are hearing it. So I said, then hear me also. No? If you are hearing that she has committed suicide and nobody has witnessed her, so then hear me also, that my daughter will not commit suicide. This is a murder, because I found blood on her bed. I have found a broken handle in the bedroom. I have seen the windows, the locks are broken, and there was a biometric lock in the entrance, which both of them had the access to it. It didn't need keys. So there are many, many reasons, and I've seen footprints on the garden, maybe as if somebody ran, because the balcony door was open. I mean, there are so many things that I showed them. No, but tell us, because I've got a lot of pressure from above, you know, I've got to have thok, yani ki, actual fact. Excuse me, how can I get actual fact? You people have got the authority, you go and catch. You have got authority, you have taken everything from my house, and you should find out. No, but we didn't see anybody coming in. I said, how? How you have not seen? We looked into CCTV. Now that is when I got alarmed about CCTV, and I said, okay, show me. So when she showed me on a laptop, so it means that that very night the CCTV from our building was taken by the police. And she showed me on her in bits and pieces. So I said, my daughter is wearing a tracksuit. Where is her tracksuit? I told my other daughter, go and look for her tracksuit. She went, she said, mommy, I can't find anywhere. So I said, please, can you ask the officer? The lady officer who came to my house, she was staring at my face. Why are you staring at my face? I said, please, can you call that officer who was on duty if he has taken the tracksuit? Till today, they never answered me. My question is that I have given them 300 pages of report, you know, Scarman's report, telling them that these are the things that you have not done and these are the questions that I want to know. Till today, it's 9 years, I have not received any question, any answer to my questions. So now looking at Sushant's and Disha Salian, it is very clear to me that these people have decided an impunity. Impunity means you tell the criminal, you signed a contract, that you tell me the truth and I will not punish you. So they all know the truth, because why these people in authority sitting on those throne will lie or will protect or will hide? What interest do they have? And let me tell you very frankly, Deepthi, the truth will never come out. They will never bring the truth out. And you, 1 year has passed, 2 years, 3 years, they will tire you as they thought they can tire me. But we as mother, we carry our child. We raise her to that height and glorify her. And somebody, some outsider, uneducated idiot, goes and kills her, right? So what is this judiciary and this law enforcement is for? Are they only to protect them?
Let me tell you, Rabia,
you understand me?
Rabia ji, nothing ever goes waste. The fight, the pain, the struggle that you have, because we have parents, we also have parents of Disha Salian, we also have parents of Divya Bharati, who have actually initially they started saying something else, but they changed. Or rather, we all know that they surrendered. You have kept up the fight. You didn't let
my go. My statements have never changed. I stand for truth. Because for truth, I don't have to, you know, think, and I don't have to create stories. I don't have to, you know, because truth always stands alone.
Exactly.
And this truth will
come out, Rabia ji, because there is a God. There is a God. Nothing goes waste. This is actually the laws of physics also same. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction, though they are strong.
Absolutely.
You have had eight years of, you know, focus, determination to bring the truth out. Everyone knows the truth now. But it's about the truth coming out officially.
Yeah, no, the higher officer said, look, the accused is our enemy also. I said, no. Says, you know, Rabia ji, we both are in same boat. I said, no, sir, we are not in same boat. Your CBI officers are sitting in the boat of an accused. And that is a very, very sad thing. Because we go to the judiciary courts thinking that, you know, it is a house of justice and we will get justice. Everyone is heard. Every poor, every rich, everybody is heard. But I don't think so that is the case over here. My voice is going to deaf ears, you know. It's just hitting the wall and coming back. So he was looking at me and staring at me. I said, yes, sir, I'm speaking the truth. This is exactly what has happened. And lo and behold, when I go back to Bombay during the court hearing, now further instructions have been given to the other IO officers. Do not part with any documents with Rabia. Do not share anything with her. I thought that I'm going to Delhi and meeting the hierarchies of agency, and my, you know, I've got some solution and my case will be sorted, and they will be, they will understand my pain and my grievances, and they will help me. But it went the other way. Now, after in these couple of years, I have discovered exactly what had happened. The truth was shining in Sushant Singh case, that how the Maha government, you know, has put pressure on these agencies, whether it is police institute or CBI agency, not to let evidences, because till today, CBI does not have any evidence from the police, neither the dupatta nor the phone. And they are with the court, and they, CBI is pleading the court to please give these evidences so that they can have forensic analysis. So I tell you, as a victim, if I would have, Dipti, you were saying that I had a private investigation. No, I never had a private investigator. What I did, the reports they gave me, I begged them through my lawyers to give me all the forensic reports from Kalina Forensic Laboratory, and all the photographs that you took, because you charged me for the photographing. So you give me all the photographs of my daughter, because you have shut the case and you don't need it anymore. So I will keep them as my sentimental value of my daughter. I took them, they gave me in writing, and I took it, I asked them in writing, and they gave me in writing. So I took that to the forensic expert in India and forensic expert abroad. Because judiciary doesn't say, it's a knowledge with somebody who has got authentication, who has got who are certified with this particular knowledge. So those knowledge are very authentic, like how your pen drive, this is authentic. So what I'm saying, that I took those reports and I submit to the court. And that was not being, and in that even CBI was opposing. Now, why CBI was opposing? Because their own forensic report was inconclusive. And why it was inconclusive? Because they didn't have the evidence handed over to the forensic. I didn't have the evidence with the forensic, but looking at all the reports, the FSL report, and the kind of muslin dupatta, you know, malmal ka dupatta, which I show, not the same, but kind of. The forensic expert said, excuse me, the injuries on the photographs, which was given to me officially by the police, and this material that you're showing, this is no way, this is a staged homicide. This is a staged murder. And they certified it, and they also wrote, we are ready to help the court in order if the court wants to witness us and summon us and call us, we are ready to come. So this is the authentication that the forensic experts have given.
Rabiaji, can you please tell me which Berkeley Institute is this? Because it might help others as well.
See, the first forensic report that I got was from AIIMS, Dr. AIIMS, R.K. Okay. Sharma, yes, who mm-hmm. is ex-dean of head of the AIIMS. He mm-hmm. gave me the first report. From his report, I went to London forensic expert, Dr. Jason Payne. Mm-hmm. And though he's also very renowned, he helps the Metropolitan Police and the United Nations for you know, a lot of criminal cases. So I took, and then I took Dr. R.K. Rajani, then I took Dr. Krishnamurthy, Hale Krishnamurthy, which is also renowned. She, Dr. Krishnamurthy runs Hale Forensic Laboratory in Mumbai. And she is the ex-director of Kalina Forensic Laboratory.
And
she is very, very respected. Very respected. All Dr. R.K. Sharma, Dr. Rajani, Dr. Krishnamurthy. So I had four forensic. And then I had a digital forensic expert giving the report that nothing in the digital world can be deleted. Like you have got encrypted documents, right? So Sushant's, whatever datas, nothing can be deleted.
Exactly.
If CBI said they cannot open the BlackBerry, that was the pressure they had, and that the accused is not giving password, right? Tomorrow accused can say, excuse me, CBI never asked us the password. I was willing to give, but they never asked. You see, there can be many, many stories. But no, what Rabia, I'm saying to CBI...
Did they seriously give you this excuse that the accused never get the password?
It is there in the charge sheet. Yeah, it is there in the charge sheet. It is there. I went to High Court, I went to Supreme Court, I have gone everywhere. Then through Supreme Court, I submitted my application. I submitted Scarman's report. I submitted all those evidences which were not even in the charge sheet. Like her photographs were not in the charge sheet. Mention of CCTV was not in the charge sheet. So many things were not mentioned in the charge sheets. The call logs do not even match the CCTV. GI is supposed to be on the call, but on CCTV, you can see her walking through the gate. And she's not on the phone. So you see, the CCTV obviously shows that it has been tampered. Or doctored.
Yes.
Whatever.
Yes.
Apart from that, CBI says, no, nobody came from, nobody entered. Okay, nobody entered. But look at the other access. What are the other accesses? CBI did not even acknowledge that there was a biometric lock and both had access. CBI did not acknowledge that the surround walls are only 4 feet, 6 feet high. And even a child can climb. I can climb at my age of 60. I can climb those walls.
I'm not sure, Rabiaji, but recently a clip got leaked on the social media wherein that particular day's CCTV shows Aditya Pancholi shifting in and out.
Aditya Pancholi came twice. I don't know, maybe he must have come thrice. I have no idea. But I came to know that he has come to my building only after I saw the CCTV that was handed over by the police to the building. Afterwards, I did not know. I was not even aware.
Deepti ma'am and Rabia ji, I just have to come here for a quick point to make. The name of the doctors that you took, and in that you took the name of Dr. Krishnamurthy ji. She is considered to be actually the benchmark of forensics. And it is indeed very, very shocking that CBI did not consider her report, because top doctors I can name in forensic 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, who have trained under her and become the top CBI director. And the top forensics for CBI directors, for the DIA, for the NIA, for so many agencies all over India. It is indeed very shocking that such a respectable doctor's claim the CBI had refuted. Point number one, ma'am. Point number two, in the video, as you said as well, the first part of the video and the second part of the video, there is a clear-cut case of time lapse. So what is someone trying to hide? See, these questions, I understand the cases and sub judice, you should not be answering this despite knowing that fact. The only reason I'm trying to raise this question without expecting any answer from you, let me be upfront to you, is because public viewers, those who are seeing the stream today, start asking these questions to the authorities. When there was a time lapse, why have you hid this time lapse? It is not Rabia ji who has to answer, despite maybe she's knowing the answer, she's not knowing the answer. But we as the public of India, if you really want justice for Jia Khan, if you really want justice for Sushant Singh Rajput, if you really want justice for yourself, ask this question to the CBI. Where is this time lapse?
Because another simple thing. I mean, it's really amusing that the CBI gave this as an excuse that the accused is not handing over the password of the phone. So that's why
That's hilarious.
That's really hilarious. I mean,
let me answer that question to you as well, Deepti ji. See, because BlackBerry was working on a software like an internet connection, which was called as Edge. Back then, I don't know if you have used a BlackBerry phone or not.
I definitely had
used one. So BlackBerry did not have this potential normal internet connection. We need to have to buy that BlackBerry pack in India, okay? So it was even the more easier for the CBI or any investigating agency to get that, because the users on that pack was less. If the accused was not giving the password of the phone, if I was the investigating officer there, I would have simply gone to the network provider and said, this is a special case. Give me the number of users who are using BlackBerry phones, and from that I myself will find out what is the password. Because network generated OTP, that was back then called as PIN number, now it is called as OTP. That PIN number would be easily generated and the phone could be opened if the intent was there in less than 6 hours.
Exactly. If the intent was there.
And no. Forget about 6 hours. See, Jia was using Z, BlackBerry Z, right? It was Z10 or something like that. So that Z10, had a GPS. Yes. Yeah, Z10. That had a GPS. For example, if you knock at my door and you say that you're at a, you know, you're not here, you're somewhere else, I'll say, no, you're lying because you're right at my door because the GPS was so precise. And the FBI forensic laboratory expert has told me, even if the phone is cracked, bomb blasted, burnt, they can get the
data recovered.
Yes, they can get recover everything. So everything. You know, nobody can fool them. They have got a special laboratory. My daughter was a U.S. citizen. FBI offered. They wrote the police officer. The head of the police officer, again, I won't name him. He refused. He said, we are very competent. If you're so competent, then why? Why those datas have not come out? Why all those text messages have not come out? The text messages, few text messages, that was on the Samsung Android, those messages were covered because they were on the top surface of Jia's phone. But what about the accuser's phone? Why did he not take? He was also using second phone because he deleted her from BlackBerry. And he was sending these messages as an alibi after she had passed away. He knew now she's no more. Exactly. So let us send messages because these alibis, this is like making a fool. You can make a fool. Yeah, exactly. You can make fool of your father or anyone, but you cannot make a fool of others. You cannot make fool of everybody.
Ma'am, Rabia ma'am and Dipti ji, for a minute, let me come in here and give another interesting angle to this. If you have noted all these deaths, no ma'am, right from the time of Parveen Babi to the time of Disha Salian, after the victim actually passed away or these people brutally murdered them, the phone was under connection as well. Now in Disha Salian's case as well, she passed away on 8th of June, but till 27th of June, the police department actually was finding that every day there was in excess of 573 MB of data. Roughly, I don't know the precise figure, some X amount of data. When the person who's using the phone is dead, how is the data being used? So, viewers, second question, please grab a pen and paper handy today. Rabia ma'am is here, Dipti ji is here, and this could be, I will come to that at the end of the show. This is the best gift I'm getting today for my special day. So please, the second question what we need to ask is, when you have some evidence and you want to send it to forensic investigation, what is the time frame you have according to your rule books? You are getting the evidence in and you're taking your own sweet time to send it to forensic investigation.
Never mind. It's okay. Because the forensic laboratory, even if the phone is dead or shattered and burnt, they can get it out. Why?
Yeah, ma'am. Why? There is something
GS phone is not...
There's something they are,
they are still asking the court, and the court, because of COVID, there has not been hearing, and it has been date after date. But never mind.
All these are excuses. All these are excuses.
Yeah. Okay. They have decided an impunity.
Yes.
They have decided impunity.
Because they will not punish. They do not want to close this. They do not want to, you know, give justice. They will keep on dragging it. Blaming someone else, some other department, that department blaming this department. They will show that they put the blame on the juniors.
The juniors, what they say, they're very lazy, they're very incompetent. You know, the officer, he said, I was new. Excuse me, you are trained, you are given this position, even if you're new, you know what is to be done. So nobody has got guts. These cases are so high profile that no one has got guts. And why does central government spend money?
Rabiaji, one thing I will tell you here, that no one is lazy or no one is incompetent. Okay. They are equally competent. They are active. But they have to give some excuses. That's why they act, but they act to bury the truth. The system, unfortunately, the legal system and the law and enforcement system in our country has become criminal friendly.
Yes, I'm sorry to say this. You have to understand what I have understood.
Yes.
Yeah, what I have understood, they glorify the criminals by saying, look, you were nobody. Now that you have done this act, and now see how famous you have become. See how you're being glorified. And now you will have more audiences. More people will like to go and see your movie or see you. Officers whose names are not popular, their names are now written with golden words. So this is what I have discovered, that they are using our children to glorify their name and to get that fame and the money and the power.
Yes, ma'am, exactly. Name, fame, money, power, yes. And also play with the emotions of the public. Because one thing what these people have constantly been doing is, when the case is in investigation or the case is in sub judice, these people bloody, I'm sorry using the wrong word, I am, with all due respect to both the ladies here, these people bloody come up with a movie, and through that movie they try and deviate people from the fact. When Arushi's case was going on in the court, if that movie did not come out, the case would have been ended in a different direction. But the movie came out and it diverted everybody, basically. Is this angle also there? This is a game that has been played. So viewers, yeah, ma'am, please.
Because ideally...
Yeah, they want to glorify. Yeah, they want to glorify and cash money.
And they want to brainwash a narrative.
Yes.
Okay, the narrative of the death, that suits their agenda. That's why they make these movies. But according to the law, I mean, if a case is under investigation, nothing on it or related, it should be, you know, a movie cannot be made. I am really surprised at the verdict of the court. I mean,
Deepthi, here I will have to interrupt. Making movie, now Hollywood also makes many, many true life stories, you know, of people who are alive and who are dead. Now, what happens
when
you make...
But not when a case is in court. It's still in court. It's still under investigation. No.
You see, it all depends upon the narrative. Now, I have to say what my knowledge is, you know, because I went through this in London regarding a lot of people wanted to make, even Hollywood wanted to make film on Gia. I declined. So when BBC came for documentary, I agreed because BBC did not do the actual documentary kind of work, because knowing that how they must have also been pressurized. Nevertheless, when you make movie, the movie makers can make movie in case the family is in cooperation. If the family is willing to give the narrative, if the family is also given that chance to be on the final edit. Do you understand me? So if you want to bring out, like Sushant's, glorify him as his childhood and as his teenage and as how he was, you know, how productive he was, how progressive he was, how he evolved and all that. It's fair. It's good enough. But if they are going to put the angle of investigation, now that can be very, very harmful. That can be harmful, because making a story on Sushant as a person, how he was, because he was in a way, if you look at it, he came to create a revolution. He came to clean Bollywood. He didn't want to see what he was seeing. So that is why after seeing your videos, it looks that he was documenting everything. And I truly believe that these are Sushant's. Because the language, the way he's thinking and the way it is not somebody who can script it in that manner. I have to say that within myself, after hearing all these, I believed to an extent that these were his mindset and these were his thoughts and these were his investigations on your pen drive.
Yes,
and I'm surprised how authorities have not... I'm surprised how the authorities have not taken you serious.
Exactly, ma'am. But you two have had the experience of how the authorities work, right?
Yeah,
you do have.
They play the silent game. They play the silent game to tell the world that you are a liar and they are right. Basically, to say that, oh, whatever. But you know, it's the very big mistake I'm making. I was listening to you and I didn't look. It didn't look that it has been concocted. It did.
And here, Rabia ji, I was involved with Sridevi ji's case as well earlier. So
I
in
didn't know
Sushant's,
that.
Yeah. So in Sushant's case, I have faced harassment in Supreme Court of India. I have faced harassment and the blocking, the injunction that blocked hearing of the case came from the Union Law Minister himself, Ravi Shankar Prasad ji, after the case was accepted. So now it is in the International Court of Justice for, you know, misappropriation and mishandling by the Supreme Court of India. So that's a different thing. I will cover about that on a separate stream or something. But the thing is, here is that it's not the lack of investigations or that the lack of evidences. It's the authorities and the agencies know everything.
And
it's the impunity. It's the impunity.
They're not interested.
They're not prepared
to
punish. They're not ready to punish.
Yes.
Yeah.
They're not ready to punish. That's the problem.
Okay, Rabia ma'am and Dipti ji, one important point let me make over here. The angle what you said, ma'am, if they want to speak about his work, if they want to glorify him, if they want to talk about the journey he made, the pains he went through, the type of genius he was, there is no problem in it. But what happens in these movies, especially in India, is because Ankur Arora case, so many cases, even the Netflix documentaries, what they do is they start it with a little bit of it, add a disclaimer, and then exactly get to the case and deviate the case in such a way that if someone who's just new, who's not known it, has just joined today, we will exactly believe what is shown to him. Because
true, because that's a perception. That's the perception. You know, to change the narrative, to change the thinking of the people. To change the thinking of the people. Oh my God, he was like that. Oh, she was like what happened with Jia Khan's case. When Jia Khan's case, I was fighting in the courts and getting evidences and things like that. While they were so busy in creating the perception of Jia being depressed, right? I have to say one thing to the accused. Yus was talking Jia Khan on Facebook in the month of September 2012, right? Jia came to London in 2010, did not want to go back to Bombay. It was one of her co-star that she had worked with. You know, he had come down they were friends. She worked with him in the Houseful and they were friends. So he had persuaded her to come back. He says, talented people like you, we need in Bollywood. And then he was giving the whole tall story, how he helped Katrina. It was not Salman, but it was him who was helping her. And he had to write a script for her. The film that, first film of his that came with Katrina. I have not seen it, but I heard the story from my daughter. So mommy, he's ready to help me and all like that. Shall I give another chance? So I said, well, you know, up to you, but sweetheart, you have to understand, your mentality is not Indian. You cannot live in that hypocritical world because they say something, they think something, and they do something. And you have been through with Sajid Khan, your producer, and you know how it is. That's the reality of Bollywood. Do you want to? Yeah, but Akshay is saying he will protect me. So, you know, it is okay. Akshay is a big name. He's a big actor and he will protect her. He will take her under his wings. Give her a try. So when she went to Bombay, probably after a couple of months, the story changed. And she came to London again. When she came, the Olympics were going, so she was having a great time and all like that. Then again, a phone call came that there is a film project, please come. So she went and she was working in London for Formula One. She was doing events for them. In fact, she appeared one with Zaheer Khan, the cricketer. Okay. So she went back to Bombay, and that is when, in the month of August, September, this guy started stalking her. And he used to live in neighborhood. So when he came to greet her, he came with flowers, and then the flowers never stopped. For 3 months, he was luring with flowers, with home-cooked food. And so Jia is living alone, poor thing. Jia had servants. She had 5 servants. She had the dog and the cat and everything. Like, she had servants in the house who were cooking food for her. But nevertheless, he was bringing food, you know, home-cooked food from his own house.
Ravage, before we move on to Suraj Pancholi, I just heard some reports, I mean, heard some hearsay. Kindly confirm if these are right or not. That Akshay Kumar was trying to woo her. I mean, you know, woo her, and she didn't return the interest or something.
Look, Akshay is madman. No, my daughter, this is a very, it's not something new in the industry, you see. Akshay, and what goes in Bollywood, you know, at the end of the day, it's a friendship, a relationship, whatever. But she is a married man. And my daughter will not have any relationship, you know, with knowing that he's married. And she's not a homebreaker. So anyway, but they were still friends. But what I'm saying, that she saw that this boy who's stalking her, so she decided to meet. Okay, let's meet. He described himself, who he is, what he wants, what are his hobbies, and he lives around the corner, and he's a gym. My daughter used to go to gym. So she used to go to some golden gym or something like that. And he used to go to a gym next door to his house. So, you know, that's how they started meeting and wooing each, you know, he was wooing her and lured into that trap. That was a trap, basically. So the first time he raised his hands was during Christmas time. And he spoiled her Christmas. And that's when I suddenly received a letter from Suraj Pancholi saying, I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry, it should have not happened, but I will not do it again. I was drunk. I lost my cool. And I spoiled Gia's Christmas. Please, I apologize. Because she was ready to leave him. So I got shocked. I said, what is this letter? I have a letter. I have that letter still. So I said, wait a minute, what happened? Says, oh, Gia and myself, you know, I lost it. I got so drunk that I lost it at her. And Gia had decided not to talk and said, mommy, he's not there in my life. And then next message I received from Gia, next day, mommy, whole night he was crying at my feet. His face was all swollen and he was apologizing. So obviously she forgave him. Somebody who's sitting and crying whole night and thinking that he will be devastated. So my daughter forgave him. So like that, you know, how many times, I said, how many times are you going to forgive him? How many times, you know, you're going to take his abuse? So you're not going to go back. When she came in February, I told her, you're not going back. And then something or the other, she signed a contract with Kwon Entertainment. And then Kwon Entertainment started calling her. But I remember 20th February is her birthday. So 23rd February, she left London in 2013. And she went back because Suraj Pancholi was going through an operation. There, he met with some accident and he had blades under his jaw. And he needed an operation. I still have Gia's text messages saying that I'm sitting next to him and he needed me. She went to nurse him because, why? Because his parents are not with him. So after this incident, after my daughter had passed away, his parents are all there for him. What happened then? Why were you not there when your son is having an operation? Why my daughter has to leave London and go and start nursing him? And telling my daughter not to, let your mother know, don't talk, tell your sisters. So you see, and Gia, yes, Gia did listen. Because Gia did love him. I will not say that she did not. But did he love her? Did he love her? And if he has, as he says, according to CBI's charge sheet, in the psychological report, it says it is him who is saying it is a suicide. So CBI is not saying that it's a suicide. It is him. So can't CBI go deeper down deep and find out why is he saying that it's a suicide? I want to know these answers.
Hello.
So guys, those are watching the show. You've got your set of questions. Let's go. Let's roar out loud. Now, Rabia ma'am, if you only want to answer this question with all due respect to you, let me put it in a more respectable way as well, because it is all you. If you want to answer it, please take this question up. One viewer is asking a question that what was the role of the Butts? Because this was widely reported all over the news that the Butts even gave you a threat that you will be like put to rest as well if you don't actually calm down. I don't want to use those words.
Yeah, that was very horrific, actually. I was crying and he walks in. Everybody was walking in. I didn't know, who is coming and who is going, because in the state that I was. But I remember that I said, my daughter has not committed suicide, sir. He says, chup ho ja, nahi to tere ko bhi injection deke suna denge. And there were my friends. Yeah, and there were my friends sitting over there. When he said that, and I just kept quiet. I kept quiet, and I was crying because I was wailing. I was crying nonstop. Obviously, this is the kind of remorse these people show. And the woman who came with that night, she said, "Arey arey, usne tumhara socha nahi. Ab tum chup ho jao. You are the one who said, 'Shut up.' You know, this is not the case of suicide. This is not the case of murder." Yeah. So these are the kind of people I was surrounded with, who was trying to change the narrative of all people who were sitting over there. One lady came, she's a religious lady, said, "Oh my God, this is not the case of suicide. This is a murder. Somebody has killed this angel." Everyone was quiet. Then a friend of mine, when I was telling her that I've seen injuries and all, she said, "Injuries, that is not suicide, that's a murder." So you understand me, people. So some people over there were very silent. They knew what they were listening to me, and they understood. And some of them were hostile because they were close friends of accused's father, Aditya Pancholi.
I can understand. I can actually visualize atmosphere.
And this is what the whole scene was. The guy, the accused, his girlfriend, as he says that she has committed suicide. You were not even there for 3 days. You didn't even come to see. You didn't even go to the hospital. You were not even sobbing. You were just showing crocodile tears because you were forced to, because camera was picking up.
Absolutely, ma'am.
Just give me a minute. I have to excuse myself.
Yes, definitely, ma'am. See, basically, I do completely agree with the statement that you just gave. If these people are scared of anything, it is only the camera, their image, their public life, and their so-called publicity stunt.
I have an interview, a television interview today.
Okay, so okay, Rabia ma'am is back. Ma'am, I definitely agree with you on this point, ma'am. The only thing these people are scared of is their public image and their face. What their people will think about them. Because if their public image or space is spoiled, no matter whatever they do, they are out. They are out completely, totally gone. It is only the image that is their consciousness. And this is where we have to attack, my dear friends. The brands, the endorsements and the policies, the Netflixes, the web streams are also need to be our target, because the only thing these people have in their hands is their power, their narratives, and the way these people portray themselves to us. You have seen these television ads where Hema Malini ji or Kajal ji or Priyanka Chopra ji uses a Lux soap in the ad. But how many of them are actually using them in their real life? Zero.
Okay, that's going into a different direction. Dhruva, let us come back. Rabia ji, yes. let us continue.
Yes, ma'am, so, please go ahead.
Diti, I want to, I mean, you have heard me quite a lot. I want to hear that I heard that you have got this pen drive about Jia and, you know, a few things that I have heard. I want to also discuss on those points.
So you want me to read them?
Yes, please.
Read yes, those please. Drives with...
Yes, okay. That... I feel very sorry that I did not know Sushant, but I remember one incident that Jia had gone to see his first film, something like Kai
Poche, yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, yeah, ma'am. And she said, "Mummy, I went to see this movie with Suraj, and I love the guy. He's so good, Mama. The movie was so good, and he is extra. I mean, one talent that I've seen." So she must have told the same thing, you know, to Suraj. He didn't talk to her for 3 days. She said, "He's angry with me because I was praising Sushant." Now that is a professional, that is a jealousy. So, you know, you can understand. And similarly, that night, because if you see Jia's text messages that police has actually given, it is in the charge sheet. He says, "Oh, why do you think that I'm jealous of you? You're jealous because she has signed 6 films and her career is going to take off. So why this message? You think that I'm jealous of you." So she must
and
have
she
said,
did not...
"We don't know." No, we don't know what she said. So that is what we are asking. That you have got few messages, 5-6 messages that he has written to her, right? But what Jia has written, can you please show us his phone? No, his phone is not with, nothing has been done with his phone. His phone was not even confiscated until, I think so, 11th of June.
That's the thing, ma'am.
Yes, that's the thing, even in...
So we need to know, there's a two-way conversation happening, right? What he's saying, we can see only 5-6 messages because they were on the surface. But what is happening, what Jia is talking about, we don't know.
And another angle of jealousy, if I put it this way, Jia Khan never needed any boy John to launch her.
Yeah.
Unlike Suraj Panchal did.
He, ever since he came, became friends with her, the father started giving him more money. Because I heard from the sources that he used to get only 5,000. Right? I mean, source is what? Anju Mahendra, who is a friend of mine and Aditya Pancholi. She gave me all the information about Aditya Pancholi. I didn't even know what Aditya Pancholi is all about, besides knowing that he was a yesteryear actor and married Zarina Wahab. That's all. What he does presently, what he does, what his activities are, I have no clue. I didn't even know that Suraj Pancholi is his son. Because I was away from industry and from India for the last 5 years. So I had no clue. It was Anju Mahendra who was giving me all the information. You understand? It was Anju Mahendra who was saying, "Oh, the father was initially very upset that Suraj is going with Jia Khan. But now I told him, no, you know, they are very young. Let them be and all. It will wear off." Okay? Who is Anju Mahendra to tell father? The father can directly tell me, "Look, I'm not very happy with your daughter going around with my son because his son is a glorified prince." You understand my point?
Absolutely. So yes, ma'am, absolutely.
So then, no, there is a very, look at this, how the plot was. Then suddenly, then, why? Because Salman Khan was going to launch Suraj Pancholi. And Suraj Pancholi's father was scared that if Suraj will be attached to some girl in relationship, then his career will be zapped. Right, so the boy went to Salman Khan, and Salman Khan had a meeting with Suraj and said, "Jia is a beautiful girl, Jia is a lovely girl," and he was okay with it, with the friendship of Suraj and Jia Khan, because this Suraj Pancholi told me himself. We had gone to some fish restaurants that belonged to his father in Warsaw. That's where he gave me all the narrative how he met Jia. And how he lured her, how he was after her, and all that narration came directly from Serpent Choli, not even from my daughter. So I said, then you started flowering her for 4 months. He took her by her arm, by her shoulder, and said, she's all worth it. I really love her. I cannot stay without. He said, I can't live alone. I said, oh, a lot of people can't live alone. No. I can't live without Jia. So I said, then what happened after Salman told you? So he came more closer to Jia. He said, yeah, it is worth it. She's very beautiful. Salman also said she's very beautiful. Okay, fine. So the relationship blossomed because Salman was okay with it. Then the boy got Jaguar, started getting brand names, you know, the brand watch. Like, I suspect, even my forensic expert was suspicious, and the CBI officer was suspicious that this mark under the chin is an imprint of a watch. And Serpent Choli is a black belt taekwondo. He's done martial arts, right? He's a black belt martial art expert. So when you hit somebody, for example, then you can have imprint of a watch. That's my perception. That's my analysis. Why was CBI asking me what watch he used to wear? Why did they ask me what kind of belt was he wearing? Now, they are asking me, the senior officer is asking me relevant questions. And I told him he used to wear a watch, big watch. And he used to wear, you know, some belt, like your casual belt that you wear on jeans and all. And he used to drive Jaguar. So obviously, the father is now giving all this, allowing the boy to flourish his relationship. And then pressurizing him. No, you're not focusing on your career. You're not focusing. So you have to put all these things together.
Exactly. Yes, I mean, see, now if I look at it somehow, Rabia ji, since Jia, too, like Sushant, is a woman of principles. Okay. I'm sure she was someone, yeah. So she was not towing the line, obviously. It's not just that, Suraj Pancholi wanted to get rid of her because he was fed up of her. I don't think that's the case. From your story, I can make out, I mean, exactly this is how Riya must have been planted into Sushant's life as well. Stalking.
Could be, you know? Yeah, could be. Because right? At that time, I was hearing many, many things of Riya's friendship, close friendship with Suraj Pancholi, Disha Salian's close friendship with Suraj Pancholi, and Sushant's fight with Suraj Pancholi. I mean, all these things were coming to me. But another thing I have to say, 5th of April, I arrived from London on 3rd of April, 2013. 5th April, Suraj Pancholi takes me to a restaurant, invites me. Jia says, I've got text message. I still have text message as proof. I've given all that to CBI, but they are not interested, of course, for vested interest. So what happened that Suraj Pancholi tells me, I want to marry you. So we laughed. I mean, he's a 23-year-old guy, and Jia is 24, going to be 25. So obviously, you know, we laughed. And so I told Jia, do you trust him? Do you trust actors? Because you can't trust actors with women. Excuse me. I don't see any actor who is so monogamous, right? So she smiled. And Suraj Pancholi says he can't live without her. Okay. He asked me for marriage. We laughed it out. 1 month later, or 1.5 months later, he comes, you know, 9:30 in the morning, when Jia has gone for an event. He comes and knocks at my door, rings the bell, I open. He's in a tracksuit, a red colored tracksuit, I very well remember. He says, I said, oh, how nice to see you. Jia has gone for an event. Says, no, she's not, she missed her flight. I said, has she? Yeah, she missed her flight. She's at my house. I said, okay. I mean, I was surprised he has come and why she has not come. So he said, I need to talk to you. I said, okay. come, sit. And his face was a little dumb. So I said, what is it? He said, I want space from Jia. I said, okay, you want space from Jia? I never introduced you. You can have space, don't contact her. Don't send her messages. Send her back home if she's at your place. No, no, I don't want to tell her right now. I said, so what did you tell her? I told her that I'm going to the doctor. I said, if you're going to the doctor, my daughter will definitely follow you, because she ran in London, you know, to be by your side when you told her that you are having an operation. So he says, so basically he told her he's going for a jog and he came to me. I came to know later from Jia. So he sat down and he started talking about his father. He started to, I said, your father is not very happy in the, with this relationship. So, you know, call it off. He said, oh, fuck my father. I said, excuse me. You're using such slang language for your father, who has bred you, has given you roof, who educated you. This is the value you're going to give to my daughter. I'm sorry. I can't stand you talking like that. So anyway, what is it that, you are suddenly thinking of space? I want to focus on my career. I said, of course, you should. That's what I want. And no, but there are a few things that are very weird about Jia. I said, weird? Like what? Says, you know, when she prepares dinner, she prepares three, four, you know, for one meal, she prepared three, four, she'll put three, four glasses, three, four. I said, Suraj, have you ever been to fine dining? In fine dining, there are always three glasses. There are different kind of cutlery. They don't know what you're going to order. So, you know, you're lucky that my daughter is setting a dining table for you. Oh, no, when I, and then she'll say, bring a bottle of wine. I said, in Italy, in London, we drink wine with food. We don't drink water. That's our choice. So, you know, she has been raised like that. She's not alcoholic. She drinks sometimes. You know, when she's happy or celebration, don't you drink? Because you wrote a letter to me saying that, you know, I lost it because I got drunk. So everybody, these days everybody drinks. And then she's saying, oh no, but one day Jia was trying to commit suicide. I said, suicide? That you never told me. You're always in constant communication with me. Jia is in communication with me. I mean, stop lying. Suraj, you lie. And you know, people who lie, they can fall bad very badly, because it's very bad karma. And now I've heard you enough, and please leave me alone. So he went away. I said, I will talk to Jia when she comes. I didn't call Jia that time. I will talk to her when she comes to me, and I will talk to her face to face. When Jia came, I spoke to her. She told Suraj, oh, this is what happened. He writes a long text message on the phone that your mother is lying. I want to live with you. You get out of that house. You rent another place and we will live like how we used to live earlier, before. So Jia showed me this message. So I said, Bebo, please, I don't want to believe in this. And I don't. I wrote a message to him. I said, so please stop playing games. Leave my daughter alone and stop playing games. I've heard you. I've seen it. You're not giving space. You wanted space, but you are not giving space to my child. So I want to go. I'm going to Kashmir and I want my daughter to come. And you are telling her not to go. So Jia says, no, 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 mommy, I've got to go for audition. So I said, okay, fine. But many a times, even going to Goa, you did not go because you wanted to be with him. And he told you not to go. So if he tells you not to go for audition, you don't go for audition. And this has happened. So this is how he started controlling. So that very night, when she discovered what has happened with the money and what how he's behaving, she said, that's it. I don't want to know him. She dumped the flowers. You can see it on CCTV. She gave up on him and she dumped him. Now, when the control slips from your hand, then you know how you can empower. Then how you feel. Nobody likes control going out of their hand. And this is the narrative that I'm giving you. I gave it to CBI.
Okay. Rabia ji, here I would also like to make a mention of the suicide note that was found. I believe one important thing that everyone...
Excuse me. No, Deepti, sorry. The suicide, no, you are mentioning it as suicide. CBI has acknowledged that this is not the suicide note. This note was written by Jia sometime, probably in the month of April or something like that, when we were there, her sister was coming, had come from London, and Surat refused to meet her. That is not. Because she has mentioned, because she, see, we did not know that Jia went through an abortion. We came to know from her. Police also did not tell us. We came to know from the note. Police never, in the statement, it doesn't say. Police did not even ask question. What about this? Police had this note. They did not ask when they were writing a statement. What about abortion? What about this? They never did any investigation. It was we who did all investigation for the police and for CBI.
Exactly. I wanted you to make this point clear, Rabia ji, because
her
this note was pushed forward by the media as suicide note. So I wanted you to make this.
And they said, I released it. The police said, I released it. No, I notarized and gave it to police. It was police who released it. After I had given to the police, after that, because police was, media was with the police, and police were telling them everything. First police said, oh, she was so drunk. So the forensic expert said, if she was drunk, and in that capacity, she would have never been able to stand. And on CCTV, you can see how she's walking, how she's talking, how she's walking. So police was trying to change the narrative of the masses.
Exactly.
But I did not change my narrative. From the day one, I did not have forensic reports and many, many reports. That is why after 4 months, when I collected it, I went to the court. I reopened the case because police had shut the case and the guy was already out, released.
So here, this is for the viewers. The thing which is widely circulated in the media is suicide note is not a suicide note.
No.
Please correct. That is just a note which was written months prior to Deepthi's death.
Deepthi, let me make it very clear. Suicide note, somebody will leave it, you know, where the place where, you know, who will come and find her, they will see the letter. Either it will be there on the place of crime, right? This note was in her Prada wallet and in the box and in the drawer. It was not even, it was when my daughter was searching for her diary, which is missing. Even the diary is missing. So that is when she found this note and gave it to the police. The police didn't do any thorough check. Police was only there to collect the crucial evidences. Who knows? Probably the tracksuit is missing because of them or because of the accuser's father and his team came that very night twice.
Exactly.
Who knows?
Exactly.
We don't know. That is the job of agency and the police to find out.
Like in Sushant's case, we have Sandeep Singh, Riya Chakravarti, everyone walking on the crime scene. It has not been sealed. People carrying things from inside. Rabia ji, you wanted to know, right, what mention was there in the slides?
Yeah, another thing I want to ask. I heard that few days before, people had arrived at Sushant's house and collected the his hard disk and other and to destroy them. So how did this escape? What will you have?
But who gave that narrative? Siddharth Pithani. Again, Siddharth Pithani. Again, Siddharth Pithani is the one who also said that he saw the body hanging. He saw Sushant hanging. So probably
I think if they came to know that he was, because I saw in one video Sushant looking very little apprehensive, or I must say little fearful, where two guys are taking him in the car. And he doesn't look very, he feels that he's not safe. That's the body language I can get. Probably they discovered that he's writing or investigating, or probably must have questioned few guys for his investigation that they must have come to know. And his life was a threat because of that?
His life was a threat because of what he has written in the drives about, you know, the connection between Bollywood, underworld,
so he must be,
the politicians.
So for investigation.
He has also written in detail about Jia Khan's murder. He has clearly stated it as murder.
Okay, let's read it.
So, I will just read it, okay. It's Jia Khan, within brackets, 20th February 1988, 3rd June 2013. Cause of death, suicide by hanging. Time of death, 11 p.m. to 11:30 p.m. My findings are as follows. The death happened before she was hanged. My course of investigations reveal that there was no trace of any undigested food in her body. And there was a plate of food on the table where the body was found. The biggest confusion what hits me at this venture is what's the time of death? Just because from 10:48 to 11:21, Suraj and Jia chatted with each other, and suddenly Rabia ji returned and found her hanging from the fan. Kartik and Neha, what connections have the two in the chats which Suraj and Jia had? And the biggest question mark which keeps me from believing this is a suicide is that she had an abortion. And this accounts to so much pain and pressure on one's mind and gives Thai the thought of revenge by default. The next important aspect that needs to be investigated is when she knew Suraj was to take her for dinner, what was dinner doing in her room? And how is it possible that there is no trace of dehydration or structural changes in her neck if she actually did suicide? I'm writing all this because after my thorough investigations that I have done with respect to this incident, I have it printed like fresh in my mind. But it's my responsibility to make the person aware of the backdrop of events that led to my findings, as these things will only come out if I am history. And I don't want to trust the system or anyone for that matter, because whenever I wanted to take this issue up, I had no support. I was beaten black and blue and was blacklisted from work too. Years of hard work got me what I didn't deserve. But I really don't care about anything. As a God-loving human being, I am following my heart and doing what is right according to my heart and my soul. The mystery unfolds as follows. My doubts that this is homicide got confirmed when CBI leaked the charge sheet online. And I did my bit trying to inform everyone who could take note of the issue by letting them know that there are a lot of evidences to prove that a hell lot of money was spent to misguide the case and damage the evidences. Today when I'm thinking on all these grounds to start up my own venture to do what I want to do, I am penning down everything so that I myself don't miss out on anything and then make a mess of things. Within brackets, 27th September 2018. I shall continue my investigations in a secret manner, as I have not many people whom I can bank on. Sarah and Saif too are putting too much pressure on me to let go of this. Okay.
Dipti, can I say something?
Yes, please.
You see, about the timings, I categorically remember leaving the house with Jia around 9:15. And you see, if I look at the call logs and the CCTV footages, so the time we are leaving, it's absolutely correct, 9:15. Jia calls me somewhere around 9:25 about film producers, that she was worried, how is she going to put on so much weight? So I said, no problem, you're going to London, so you will put on weight. Then I send her a message around 9:36. These are the call logs that I'm seeing. So 9:36, after that, around 11 o'clock, Aditya Anjoli walks in because I was sitting at Anjum Andrew's house. I see him very intimidating. So I left. I left within 5 minutes. I reach home around 11:14 or 11:10, whatever. So the call log, for the call log, the first call I make to Anjum Andrew is at 11:20. So that means I by the time I pay the rickshaw, I go to my house, I open the door and I walk in and I go, at least 3 minutes are gone. So I make a phone call at 11:20. So I must have seen Jia's body around 11:16, 11:17 or something. Right?
Yes.
So that means her death happened somewhere between half an hour before.
Okay.
So those timings, you see, I won't blame Sushant because Sushant was not there and a lot of information is not out there in public. This I'm talking about the call logs that I have from the police charge sheet and the CBI charge sheet.
Okay.
Now regarding that there was food or anything, he must have got mixed up that she had dinner with Suraj a night before in Marriott. But that day, there was no dinner, where she was found. There is no dining table around there.
Rabia ji, the timing that you are saying and the timing that is mentioned here is the same. He says it's between 10:48 to 11:21.
Yeah.
What was declared? Yeah. What was declared in the media earlier? He mentioned it as cause of death was suicide by hanging, and time was of that was given as 11 p.m. to 11:30 p.m. But later, when he explains about his investigations, he says that the time of death just because from 10:48 to 11:21. Okay.
Just
so a minute.
Tipu, can I have water, please? Sorry. I'm sorry. I'm thirsty.
You are saying something about the food.
Yeah. So the food, she didn't consume any food. Yes, she had orange juice. She had orange juice.
Okay.
Not at her, at her friend's house. And that is what was found in the postmortem.
Okay. Yeah, he says that there was no trace of any undigested food in her body. He also said the same thing. But he says that there was a plate of food on the table where the body was found.
No.
Was it so?
No. That was not.
Okay.
Well, Deepthiji, if I don't disturb the both of you wonderful ladies, let me come in here for a minute. Sushant was neither an investigation guy or anything. Sort of the 100 points were written, if 85 points are also right, that means he put an effort over there.
Yeah, absolutely. I would. He must have presumed. You see, he must have, somebody must have told him that, the Khana was there and all like that. But because the thing was, that Anjum Andrew cleaned the feces and the urine, not the food.
Okay. All right. So I will read out another slide where there is some mention here. People trying to suppress my findings in what is the truth and dictate terms on me, whether I should continue or I should not. I am doing my bit to keep that innocent soul motivated on the movie sets, but all I get in return is troll for trying to do what my heart is telling me to. Jia had gotten to know a lot of things, and my limited interactions with her makes me want to ask these following questions to my mind.
Coming to this point that Jia knew a lot of things, perhaps because she used to be very suspicious that many a times the boy used to disappear, not tell her where he is, what he is, you know, like now you're in a relationship, there's a lot of transparency. You do tell each other where you are, whether you're sitting with your mother, whether you're sitting on the set or whatever. So she used to be very suspicious. That is why she was thinking, you know, is it that he's two-timing me or what it is? And she was also suspicious about, according, even Suraj has admitted in his statement about his boyfriend, maybe school friend or whatever, Karan Joshi. She used to be suspicious about their relationship also. Now, the thing is, what they do together, what it is, you know. So she was not very clear about that. For this reason, many a times, like she must have tried to get into his phone or he must have tried to get into a phone or, you know, in a relationship, you want to find out everything. So there used to be fights because otherwise, why Suraj Pancholi beat Jia Khan? Why will he fight with her? When you are so much in love that you're telling his mother, her mother, that she's my dream girl and she's my world. So why are you beating her? And if she's so depressed, obviously, then why are you with a depressed? No. If she's so depressed, then why are you with a depressed girl? What are you doing with a depressed girl? Why are you making love with a depressed girl? Do you understand me? They create depressed story. Another thing I will tell you, do depressed people are not killed? Are depressed people not killed? Most of the homicidal cases where the depression stories are, the cases are of homicide.
Exactly. That's right.
Because that's depression right. is the easiest way out.
And it happens, are
disabled. Okay. Even if a person is disabled, are disabled people not killed?
Exactly. Exactly.
So stop fooling people. But do the investigation and come with the truth beyond reasonable doubt.
Exactly. Yeah. So, yes, I will continue.
Yeah, continue.
So number one, why did Salman Khan transfer 2 crores to the commissioner's account? I found this out and tried to investigate this angle, only to know that the account now ceased to exist as on 30th September 2018. What was the motive behind this transfer? But what is the most shocking is that this transfer has happened on 24th of February 2013. Does this mean that the entire incident was pre-planned? And the cover-up was ready even before the crime actually happened? Being Human is an NGO kind of organization. And what are Salman's intentions behind the transfer? Suraj Pancholi was carrying cash amount of 5 crores. Why was he carrying so much cash? And why was this not brought out when he was arrested and also when he was in custody? Back then, I was not involved in this case. But a casual interaction with an intoxicated Suraj and him telling with his own mouth that he was carrying cash to bury the matter, where is this heading to now? 3. Jia and Suraj were partying in Goa. Why did the Atul Agnihotri family join them all of a sudden? And what is the discussion that happened here, which made Jia blurt out in her suicide note that Suraj ruined her Christmas? And also didn't spend Valentine's Day with her. And also the promise that was made to her by Suraj that he will get engaged to her very, very soon. Number 4. As per the network and tower signals and the story that was put out, Suraj very well knew Jia was to meet him. But what made him avoid her when she landed up in her house by telling he is in a meeting with Aditya Pancholi? And the most important matter here is that Kangana Ranaut, Suraj Pancholi and Aditya Pancholi, something seriously is cooking up here. And now when I rewind the entire incident in my mind, I begin to feel everything that is going on from years is a massive cover-up to establish it for the fact that people are targeting the Pancholi family. So getting back to the initial point, the story of Suraj sending Jia back is having connections to Kangana in one way or the other. I cannot conclude on Kangana's involvement, but can for sure say one thing is these questions that are being put to her from my trusted sources
was Jia not a fellow actress? And why is the entire judiciary trying to play foul with everything when it comes to one question? What is the truth behind Jia? I forgot. I cannot conclude. Yeah?
Diti, I'll interrupt over here. That night, Jia, you see, Jia had given money to Suraj to give it to Neelu for jewelry. And Suraj next day had a change of mind. So she was suspicious. Probably he has decided now, you know, to keep the money for himself or whatever. And that is why they were fighting. He was behaving very cold. And, you know, suddenly he... So either Suraj knew what is going to happen, because the night before they are having dinner at Marriott, and suddenly, you know, next day they have changed their changed attitude. Now, in Suraj's statement, I heard him saying that Jia had told him that she's going to London. Yes, she had told him that she's going. She was going for the film. She was filming, and CBI confirmed that coming following Thursday, Jia was going to London. And she was going for the film and would be back within a week. But that was not the reason that they broke. They never broke. The reason was that next day, when he decided not to give money to Neelu, and that is where the fight started. She goes and she is telling him, I have signed the films, I want to celebrate. Can't you be happy for me? Why is he not happy for her signing the film? Why is he feeling suddenly so cold and jealous that he's avoiding? If she has signed the film, you should celebrate. You should come to mother's house. You came that day on the 18th of May to say you want space. And now she's getting film and she's getting work. And you're eating dinner from her pocket money at Marriott at her own expense. And you're not even feeling happy that she has signed films. And you're avoiding going with Karan Joshi to probably blow up the money that she has given. So anyway, so they have a fight. She goes to his house. She calls Deva, that the servant of Suraj Pancholi. And Deva says to Suraj, it's Jia on the phone. He says, tell her I'm with the father. And Jia is standing at the window, watching that he's not with the father, but sitting with his friend. So the servant says, oh, but Jia was standing over here and she saw everything. So as soon as Jia heard this, that Suraj is lying, she left. Suraj sends Karan Joshi, go and find out which direction she's going. You don't want to talk to her. You say you have amicably broken. She's traveling, going back to London. She doesn't want, you don't want to know her. You are saying that she's crying about mother, all the fake stories you're telling. And the statement is saying something else. And why then you have to tell Karan Joshi to find out where she has gone? What interest you have got, whichever direction she has gone to? CBI and police did not cover up this side of the story. They did not follow up. They did not ask the watchman, which direction do you see Jia going? Did Jia come to visit? Do you see and there are 14 CCTV from Suraj's house till my house. There is ISKCON temple. ISKCON temple has got 5-6 CCTV on the road. Not one single CCTV footages have been investigated. Why? If you call this an investigation, we are not investigating officers. We are just common people. We are just a mother in grief, grieving for her daughter. I am raising these questions. I went and I saw. I still have got footages in that house, which the house that they had confiscated from some old man, which Supreme Court told them to vacate the house. In that very house, there are CCTVs. Police could have collected. So these are the reasons that I'm telling you that CBI and police, they have their vested interest not to do it. Why? Because they have pressure of the government. It's a simple thing.
Exactly, unfortunately. Unfortunately, the same thing has happened. Yeah. The same thing has happened with me regarding Shridevi's case as well, Rabia ji.
Yes.
I mean,
all these cases. Sushant and Disha Salian. My heart goes for Disha Salian, the way they have sabotaged the whole thing. Sushant, you know. Now, let me tell you one thing, Aditi. I've heard your thing. To a great extent, I must say hats off to Sushant for investigating, going into such details, because he was not present, but he was investigating. He's done a better job than even police and CBI has done. So let me tell you that CBI, if they wanted, they could have gone, tapped the door of High Court, that I am not getting any evidence from police. Do you understand me? They could have gone and tapped.
They didn't want.
They could have gone to Supreme Court. They got this case last year. They could have. The poor father does not have to do it. I have been doing all this. Who is going to go for Sushant? I have gone to Supreme Court, to High Court. If you see numerous times, every month, twice there was a hearing. I have gone. I have started the trial. The case was shut. I got it reopened. Who is going to go for Sushant? Who is going to go and spend that kind of money? The criminals have got deep pocket.
Exactly, with
that deep pocket, they create the fear. So, you know, the officers are fearful. The judges are fearful. The system is fearful. Everybody is fearful. I remember going to magistrate court asking to exhume my daughter's body because they hurriedly, you know, they did it. Because I was in a semi-comatose when they were burying my child. You tell me, the magistrate court judge was so reluctant that his feet went cold. In High Court, one of the judges, lady judge, she said, please don't bring this case in front of me. This is the situation of the judges. They have no guts.
And here,
the magistrate court judge said, please don't bring this case in front of me. Wait for the judge who is, I don't want, go to High.
Yes, Ravish, that actually matches with what is mentioned here about some exchange of heavy, you know, transfers that have happened with regarding just before and after this incident. Okay, so obviously, we see here that the CBI and everyone has borne down. I mean, they have bent in front of money and money power and influence and... I don't know. It is unfortunate.
And I will use the word influence rather than anything else, because they can be influenced. They can be threatened. They are also, they are family people. They, you know, it is whoever, like in film, like in Bollywood, whosoever, one actor, Vivek Oberoi, he raised voice. What happened to his career? So similarly, one officer or one, you see, everyone is holding on to their thrones. Everyone is holding on to their titles. They have got job. They have got families to feed. So they are telling us in a way, "Arey bhai, ab be silent, chup ho jao, ab jaane do, ab wo wapas to aayegi nahi. Arey wo wapas nahi aayegi, par ye jo zinda hain, jo ghoom rahe hain, ye to aur maar denge."
Exactly. Exactly.
और मारा ना सुशांत को एंड दिशा सालियन को. दिशा जिया के वक्त अगर पकड़ लिया होता तो ये मौतें ना होती.
जी.
आप समझ नहीं बात. Because यही लोग हैं जिन्होंने जिया को मारा, जो पूरी की पूरी टोली जो उसके पीछे खड़ी हुई है, वही सुशांत एंड दिशा के केस में कोई फर्क नहीं.
सही है. वही. I mean, बहुत सारे.
अरे कौन है और कौन सुनता है राबिया खान को? कौन सुनता है एक माँ को? अरे वो बोलती रहेगी, कोई बात नहीं, थक जाएगी, उसके पास तो इतना पैसा है नहीं. But they forget the power of God. No, they forget the power of God.
Exactly. लेकिन आपने जो बोला है, अगर जिया खान के वक्त हम लोग सभी आवाज उठाते हैं, अगर आपका मतलब ये होने नहीं देते, अगर उनको अगर तभी सजा मिलती, तो आज सुशांत, दिशा, श्रीदेवी जी, ये सब शायद मतलब अभी होता नहीं, सभी जिंदा होते.
Yes.
आप ये सही
yes.
बात बोल रहे हैं. Justice denied is delayed is justice denied. Justice delayed is justice
It's denied.
At least सब लोग.
Yeah. Cherry picking.
Exactly.
इनको against
और एक जन थे जो सुशांत को हेल्प कर रहे थे, ये जिया खान के केस में इन्होंने लिखा है यहाँ पे कि मैं ये बता दूँ. सो गेटिंग बैक टू द इनिशियल पॉइंट दैट द स्टोरी ऑफ सूरज सेंडिंग जिया बैंक इज हैविंग कनेक्शंस टू कंगना इन वन वे और द अदर, आई कैन नॉट कंक्लूड ऑन कंगनास इन्वॉल्वमेंट, बट कैन फॉर श्योर से वन थिंग इज दैट शी नोज अ लॉट अबाउट दिस एंड व्हेन शी इज स्पीकिंग लाइक अ लाउड स्पीकर. Why is she not having answers to my questions or the questions that are being put to her from my trusted sources? Was Jia not a fellow actress? And why is the entire industry trying to play foul with everything when it comes to one question? What is the truth behind Jia Khan? Asif Bhai too has tried his ways out to get to the roots of the matter and is one prime support to me. When this issue is of concern of the very few people who are genuinely good, and even Asif Bhai backing off now gives me the clear cut feelings that this incident needs to be investigated thoroughly and make sure that the truth is out very very soon. So in trying to investigate further into Jia Khan's death, Sushant was discouraged by Sara Ali Khan, Saif Ali Khan and from everyone in the industry. Okay, he was boycotted.
Yeah, because it's a normal thing. Now, bolenge, arey, yeah, it's a normal thing. Bolenge, kyun tum, you know, why you are doing this? You know, unnecessarily. You know, you will, you know, these people are too powerful. These people will get on your back, and so I will not say Sara Ali or Saif. A lot of people came up to me also. Said, "Ki arey, chodo. You know, they are very powerful. They are this. Tereko maar denge and all." Maine kaha, "Maar denge, bas." मार ही देंगे ना, क्या उनको ताज मिल जाएगा मारने का? वो तो ऑलरेडी पहने हुए हैं ताज, और क्या करेंगे? सिर्फ मार सकते हैं, वो बना नहीं सकते, वो किसी को कुछ बना नहीं सकते इस दुनिया में. वो अल्लाह की और भगवान की हर चीज को डिस्ट्रॉय कर सकते हैं. दैट इज ऑल दे कैन डू, यू अंडरस्टैंड, बिकॉज दैट इज व्हाट दे आर केपेबल ऑफ, बट दे आर नॉट केपेबल फॉर एवर. उनका भी दिन आएगा, उनको भी मारने वाला कोई खड़ा हो गया होगा. कमिंग टू कंगना रनावत, यू सी, मे बी शी इज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री एंड शी वाज इन्वॉल्व विद आदित्य पंचोली, बट आई हर्ड हर इंटरव्यू इन आपकी अदालत और समथिंग लाइक दैट, व्हिच हैड एक्सपोज्ड हाउ शी वाज अब्यूज्ड. एंड एक्चुअली एवरी इंसिडेंट दैट हैपेंड टू हर, एक्चुअली my daughter went through the same thing with her boyfriend, same thing, same incident. It's like father like son. So if she knew, so it doesn't take a rocket scientist, you know, to know what is happening to Jia Khan, because it happened to her. But thinking that any other way about Kangana, I am not very sure about all that, but after listening to her interview, it made it very clear to me that she must have definitely felt. Yes, I heard a lot of people afterwards told me that she passed a remark about Jia's mental health and all. I said that is when she did not know the real facts. She's also going along with whatever everybody is saying because she didn't know Jia. She did not know her mental state, and nobody knew except us. And those who knew were the part of the cabal.
Exactly.
So they were silent. And most of the part of the cabal was there at the funeral trying to keep me quiet, trying to keep the media at bay. You understand me? So the information that Sushant got and the information that he's putting on paper, it is by his mindset, and it is also some hearsay. It is also from his sources that he trusts. I will not make a comment on that, but definitely say that yes, he has done his homework and he was trying to get to the root of the cause.
So maybe going forward, if I come across more material, I will always share it with you, Rabia ji. Yeah. And thank you so much. I mean, people should know the truth.
I tell you, Deepthi, you have... No, Deepthi, I tell you, this boy, whose name is Sushant, the way I've heard you and the way I'm hearing all this and the way he went risking his life, he wanted to clean Bollywood. It says now when there is too much dirt, even the oceans, you know, throw it out at the shore. Even oceans cannot consume that much filth. So similarly, this boy must be seeing so much filth in the industry that his conscious mind definitely did not allow that he can bury the matter. He wanted to do something about it. There are many, many good souls, you know, who want exactly. to bring, save innocent lives, and they want to bring justice to all those vulnerable ones who are left with injustices.
But unfortunately, the system, the ecosystem of the entire, you know, not only the Bollywood. See, these people are getting away with their crimes because they are being supported by the, you know, law and
but this happens everywhere
and the judiciary. Deepthi,
this happens everywhere. This happens even in America. Even in America, you give $500,000, you will get away with murder. So these things happen all over the world. But what I'm
that
trying to
what?
Say, if a nation, if the leaders want to clean up their nation, I mean, and keep their citizens secure, then they have to do something about it. Because if we individual will stand up and all like that, look what happened to Sushant. What happened to Disha?
There's the reason.
What happened to my daughter?
See, if the authorities and the agencies are not doing their duty, there's the reason we should come out. We should come out, and as a public, because they have a
Money. The money and power is the reason. Yeah, money and power.
Yeah, but
you see, they increase the salaries of these investigating officers.
But they have an image to protect as well. They have an image to protect as well. Okay, whatever their priorities are, they have an image to protect as well.
Yeah.
If we come out in the open and people are aware of the real faces behind the masks that they are projecting, that is when actually we can change this, Rabia ji.
See, the criminals have got more reason to save their image. That is why they pay, and that is why they shut the mouth of agencies and say, don't investigate. Do you understand
exactly.
me? Because they want, because they want to get the fame and power. I mean, how desperate are those people who are rubbing shoulders with them? How desperate are they?
Exactly.
Think of them also. So it's all desperation situation.
No.
It's all money and power.
Okay, Deepthi ji and Rabia ma'am, there are some questions from the audience. If you both permit me, I would like to ask some questions. So, first and foremost question was, ma'am, did not anyone from the Bollywood industry actually at least try to help you?
Abhi aap bataya, bichara ek Sushant jo, you know, was trying to help Bollywood, in fact. Uska kya hal kiya?
Yes,
I remember somebody saying, don't even mention Shush, because जो भी मेंशन करेगा उसका तो उसका क्या हाल होगा बॉलीवुड में आप देखो बॉलीवुड पीपल आर सो कवर्ड सो डेस्परेट बिकॉज दे थ्राइव ओनली ऑन दिस यू नो इनसिक्योर जॉब्स एंड हु इज गिविंग देम जॉब्स दीज आर पीपल हु आर एम्पावरिंग देम एंड हु आर डूइंग द क्रिमिनलिटी इन बॉलीवुड
यस मैम I completely agree to your stand. And now the next question, ma'am. This 2 to 5 crores of transaction which Suraj was supposedly carrying, were you aware of this? Were the police or the agencies have told you about this, ma'am?
Agencies were telling me indirectly that they are very rich. So I said, so? How does it matter? See, I have never dealt with agencies. I've never dealt with it. So I was now, after 8 years, I've discovered why they were asking me. Why they were asking me what are my assets? Why they were asking me what, telling me what assets they have got? Because obviously, the criminals have got deep pockets. So I heard in 2013, after Jia had passed away, that the accuser's father has sold his house for 5 crores. That I know, I came to know this from the accuser's family themselves.
Okay.
So this so
it could be that. It could be that money.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Because in CBI's charge sheet, it only mentions that they collected 3.5 lakhs when they raided Suraj Pancholi's house. So that 3.5 lakhs, they never questioned where did it come from. Was it the money that Jia gave for jewelry? Yes. You see, you understand my point? My question is, my daughter had 10. She gave 5. Or maybe she gave 6.
Yes,
because the money, that's the money CBI recovered from his house.
Okay. Fantastic. Ma'am, actually, I'm sorry I put up this question. I did not really want to take this question up. But some people in the chat have gone to the extent of telling that it is me or Deepthi who has written these drives, not by Sushant. So, certain points which have come up in the drives as well, which you just confirmed, was unknown to anyone. It was at least unknown to people unless and until they've gone into the depth of this matter. Like what you just said. And what Deepthi ji was reading out, I was able to connect certain points somewhere. Because what is happening is, ma'am, from the time any case comes into picture, from the time of Divya Bharati till recent of Vijay Chitra, I'm not sure if you have heard of her or not. She was a small-timer, real, like a Sushant of South, a new actress, highly talented and stuff. People have been very busy spreading these conspiracy theories around rather than trying to support the effort someone was putting, ma'am. That's why I wrote some questions. And
no, I was listening. I was listening to your tapes, whatever the script is, encrypted documents. How much can one, construe a story? How much one do it? Do you understand me? There is a limit to it. All these things, that the way everything is functioning, the way things are happening, they cannot be construed until somebody has really gone deep into some investigation, or somebody who's inside that industry.
Yes, ma'am.
You two this people are not part of an inside of the industry.
No, ma'am. No.
You cannot go to that level. Where Sushant could go, where Jia could go.
Exactly, ma'am.
And there is another stupid question here by one gentleman. I'm sorry, ma'am. Chadda Majumdar ji, how could Sushant write about Asif Basra and Sandeep Nahar when they died after SSR?
Yeah.
Sir, when he was writing it,
who are they?
They are two of the 14 to 16 people who died mysteriously around Sushant's death, right after or before them. They all were close friends of Sushant.
Yeah, so how they were helping Sushant?
Here it's written that Asif
Bhai... Were they investigating with him?
Asif Bhai...
Yeah, so they were investigating with him.
Yes, so they were
helping... So they were investigating with him, no? So obviously, listen, when you do investigation, it's a watertight security. You understand me? It's a watertight, little bit of leakage. You had it. So if anything has leaked, their life is in danger. Whether they die before or they die after. That's not the point. The point is that the watertight has been leaked. Even the Titanic was drowned by the small leakage. So I, if these guys were helping him by giving information, whatever they were gathering, I cannot completely put two together that they were investigating. And when you are possibly, you know, under the influence of alcohol or while making love to your girlfriend, you do spill out something or the other. So this planting of Riya Chakravarti and the girlfriends and all these friends, obviously the leakage will be there. Probably, maybe Sushant must have leaked, but by mistake, thinking he can trust. I'm just saying it out of my own mind.
No, he has written it.
You see, kabhi kabhi that aisa hota hai.
Rabia ji, unhone likha hai. He has written that he has done some mistakes and he was betrayed. He has clearly mentioned that. Okay.
So I'm right.
Yes.
So his life, then definitely his life was in danger. 100%. I am surprised at how police, nobody has taken, even Bollywood icons have not taken these drives seriously.
Because they all know. They all know what happened and what's happening.
Ma'am, the Bollywood guys, if they would not have taken the drive seriously, I am not actually taking up comments which are negative here. If I would have read out all the comments that are coming in the chat section, we would actually have known how seriously these drives have been taken and how seriously are people trying to feed into the minds of people that these drives are fake. See, me, first question that comes up in the chat is either me or Deepthi have written these drives. Second question that comes into the chat is, when Asif Basra and Sandeep Nair passed away after Sushant, how could Sushant mention about them? People do not have this capacity of UOYB, that is, use their own brain, that when all the three were alive, these investigations were happening.
And nowhere has he mentioned about the death.
I understand.
And nowhere has he mentioned about the death in this. He is just talking about their help that they were extending. So obviously at that point of time, they were awake. They were alive. So anyway, that's not a question to be even considered because it doesn't make sense.
I can completely understand.
Now, Deepthi ji and Rabia ji, we are 2 hours into the stream. And a part of the healthy discussion has been done with the both of you. Now, if you both permit me, there are certain, like, what do you say, some definitely genuine people down there who wants to interact with you and Rabia.
No, let us. Yeah, yes, but let us stick the, I mean, you know.
No, I want to hear Deepthi. She wants to tell me something.
Okay, Deepthi ji, please go ahead.
Yes, Rabia ji.
Now, you want to tell me something about...
No, I'm saying that to the questions, to the people who are saying that how could he mention Asif and Sandeep Nahar when they died after Sushant. I said when he was writing in these notes, they were alive, right? They were alive and helping each other. He has nowhere mentioned about their death in these drives. He has just mentioned that they are helping him in these investigations. So that's why I wanted to make that answer clear. Yes. And
police has investigated their death? Police has not investigated their death?
Suicide. They have given it a suicide note. He has left a suicide note for the wife. Another in Asif's case. I mean, you can just, there are videos made on their murders as well. It is mysterious. Again, shoddy investigations.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. There are 14 to 16 friends of his. And Disa Shalyan also, she is a celebrity manager. Okay, she obviously must have been helping Sushant because she has many secrets, right? She is a celebrity manager, means she has access to that.
And not one celebrity came to say. Yeah, did any celebrity say that Disha was depressed?
I don't know. I haven't followed that case actually. I'm just.
No, there was none. Yeah. There was none who said she was depressed, ma'am. There was none who said she was depressed.
I tell you, people are so covered. And until unless the movement does not start, you know, you don't come out, forget about any of these victims getting justice.
Exactly. That's the reason we
without a movement, yeah. Without movement, forget it. I have taken a closure. I know what has happened. I know, and I'm happy that those who have sucked money out of criminals, I wish them to suck more. I wish that their bags are empty and all the money is distributed to the poor.
Exactly. That's the reason we are making this. That's the reason we invited you to talk, so that many people become aware of what exactly is happening. That is when there will be a movement, yeah. Rabia ji. People are not aware. Yes. So that's why it is our attempt to spread this truth to the people, these buried truths. Because mainstream media will never cover it.
It's not you. Deepthi, it is not you. It is Sushant's spirit that is making you do. How miraculously you got hold of this pen drive. How miraculously everyone is listening to you. It doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen.
It is his soul.
Yes, I wasn't even following Sushant's case.
And by the time, yeah, how it's God who chose you? Because I heard a couple of your Meena ji's videos, and you were reading out the encrypted documents. It didn't look that you know. It looked that the boy was like a James Bond investigative, like he would have been very, very, very good probably in this field, because he was an engineer and he was looking at how it is engineering. How are these things being engineered?
And also he was
who is the engine? Yeah, who is the source of energy in this? Who is making these moves? Who is making this machinery move? He's only a person with that, you know, scientific engineering mind can do it.
Exactly.
CBI asked me, what is my qualification? I said I was a biochemist student, biochemistry. Now, because studying biochemistry, you have that sense of investigative mind, sense of engineered mind. That how these formulas fit, how these things fit. That's why I raise question. It's a common sense.
Exactly.
They can't say that they were lethargic and they're very tired and they don't have competency. No, they have competency because they are trained in that. It's their profession, it's their career.
Thank you so much for being such a strong woman, Rabia ji.
Yeah.
Thank you, because yes, you have been relentlessly fighting. That is why the change will come now. I mean, for all this, you didn't give up. 8 years, 9 years, the fight continues.
But Deepthi, I'm not fighting. I'm not fighting for revenge. I don't have any revenge.
For justice. No,
I am
justice.
Fighting for truth. No, for truth.
Truth.
Ke sach ko samne lekar aao. Dekho, justice upar wale ka hota hai. Justice is a very heavy word. You understand me? Dono palle hote hain. But sach le aao.
Exactly. Officially.
Agar aap kehte hain, overrule one over the other. Overrule murder and say it's a suicide. Overrule suicide and say it's a murder. But overrule one thing or the other, na? Aap to kuch bhi overrule nahi karte.
Silence.
बस जो मन में आ गया कह दिया या
एग्जैक्टली आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड जी ध्रुवा जी आई थिंक समवन वांटेड टू लेट अस जस्ट कीप इट टू जिया जी केस not direct discussions.
No, Deepthi ji, actually, like a couple of people want to join the stream and ask a couple of questions to Rabia ji and you. I can vouch on certain people like maybe Priyanka ji, or maybe M. Rekha ji, or maybe a Freeze Bhai, or some people who are definitely genuine and can like not spoil the decorum of the stream, if allowed, because this is your stream from where it is happening. Can we take a couple of viewers inside? With all due respect, if allowed.
Just the names mentioned.
Okay. One question per user. One question per user is also fine, because certain nice questions are coming up, which I feel will add value to it. And yes, I will just post the questions here. I will just like invite the people, those who want to join the stream, because M. Rekha ji, as I said you, she has been doing some fantastic analysis around the, what do you say, back to basic show and a lot of stuff. So if she comes on the stream, she can actually put some light on some things as well. So with all due respects, I would invite some selected people who will ask genuine questions, ma'am. I'm just going off stream for a minute so that I can channelize, communicate and get them on. Kindly give me a minute. Deepthi ji, you can please continue from here.
So, Rabia ji, abhi kya hai? What is the standing of the case now? I mean, kya hai abhi, filhal? Present standing.
Bas yehi hai ki, CBI is asking the court to give the evidences so that they can send you forensic laboratory. Like BlackBerry, jo khul raha tha un logon se.
After so
and,
many years.
Like dupatta, jo bhi tak, after so many years. Ab ye bhi nahi malum ki asli dupatta hai ki kya hai. Because ek dafa jab case khola tha, to judge ne pucha tha police se, ki wo kis tarah paayi gayi thi. To unhone kaha rope thi. To hamare phir counsel ne kaha ki nahi ji, dupatta tha. It was a muslin dupatta. So the court said ki please reinvestigate the case, which police didn't do. That's why I went to CBI. I had to fight to the nail. और अभी भी क्या क्या होता है कि अगर मैं जाऊंगी तो आपकी स्ट्रीम बहुत लंबी हो जाएगी. Never mind, कभी और कैच करेंगे. लेकिन I have to say, जो आप कर रही हैं, जो आप acknowledge कर रही हैं लोगों को, it is a good thing in a way कि nobody has taken so serious. Why? Because at least सबको सुनने में मिल जाएगा. Everyone will know it. उसके बाद when everybody will know and the public perception will change, that's when authority will think that they have made a mistake. Because उनकी आदत है हर चीज को, हर सच को छुपाना.
Exactly. Exactly.
हर सच को छुपा दो, बस इसको छुपा दो. अभी वो लोग कहते हैं कि पब्लिक, वो चुप रहेंगे तो पब्लिक आपको बिलीव नहीं करेगी. बट कब तक? सच नहीं छुपता. जब सच साबित हो जाएगा जो हो रहा है, it will be too late for them.
Exactly.
Okay. It will be too late. It's so, good in a way.
Yeah. Okay, I'm back. So, M. Rekha ji, please check your Twitter DM. Priyanka ji and Deepthi ji, you can check your WhatsApp chat and Twitter DMs as well. I've sent you the link. Please join. If you want to ask, join and ask one question, please join. Okay. M. Rekha ji, please go ahead.
Hi. Thank you, Dhruva. Namaste, Rabia ma'am. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Rabia ma'am, I want to tell you, I lost my dad 25 years back. Similar incident. Of course, it wasn't stated as a suicide or anything, but there were politicians involved. It's been 25 years. The CBI has not been able to help us. So I totally understand where you come from. And we gave up. We couldn't fight as strongly as you did. So my heart goes out to you. And we're all standing strong with you. I don't have anything to tell you, because I mean, I can only say that I get goosebumps every time I see you. And, you know, I see the kind of effort you're putting behind your daughter. So much, much, much love to you. We are always with you. if at any point you could come to a platform like that of Republic or a larger platform and, you know, tell the people how the politicians, how these cricketers and how Bollywood is all, you know, ek hi thali ke chatte bate. And you know, we must now really boycott them completely if we want a good future for our children in the country. It will be huge help because log aapko sunenge kyunki log jante hain ki aapne kitna effort kiya hai.
My dear, thank you and thank you so much for your empathy. Ye Republic ne actually kafi khulasa kiya jiska repercussion Republic ko bardasht bhi karna pada. And you know what they went through, what Arnav went through. My hat's off to him and my heart goes to him. But it is a known thing now. And if you think, you know, that I will get, my daughter is going to get justice, it will be a divine justice, my dear. And I'm prepared for that.
I agree.
And I have understood the judiciary machinery, whatever it is, it's a money-making thing. Sab paisa bana rahe hain, to bana rahe hain unko. Unki rozi roti inke inhi ke haathon ki hoti hai, criminals ke haathon ki. To bana do na unko. They know also how karma catches. They know also ki ye khoon ke aansu hai, ye khoon ki roti hai. To khane do. Hum to nahi kha rahe na.
Bilkul. So,
ध्यान ही मत दो उस तरफ. वो मैं कहती हूँ अगर मैं 10 रुपए खर्च करती हूँ तो वो 1000 रुपए खर्च करते होंगे
जी,
आप समझ रहे हैं? तो फिर इट्स अ स्टेक, तो करने दो. मैं तो बहुत खुश हूँ. मैं तो कहती हूँ उनकी पूरी थाली एम्प्टी हो जाए और सारा पैसा अथॉरिटीज को मिल जाए. एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इन्होंने कौन सा लीगली कमाया है?
करेक्ट.
इनकी कौन सी लीगल की लीगल कमाई है?
सही कह रही
हैं. यू नो आई एम नॉट लुकिंग फॉर ऑल दैट क्लोजर जो उन्होंने ऑलरेडी साइन कर लिया कि और एक एक बोला था कि बस देना ही नहीं है इसको.
रविया जी, अगर उनको लगता है कि हमें चीजें समझ नहीं आती हैं तो हमें सब कुछ बिल्कुल समझ आता है. Crystal clear दिखता है. We know who are the people. We know what they have done. I mean, probably in the court of justice, they have not been accused so far or, you know, punished. We know and we have. And Dipti ji, keep going. Don't worry. People will say good and bad all the time. You have to keep believing in what you're doing and keep going forward with that. Rabia ma'am, at any point, if you need us, you want us to raise our voices, to speak for you, go stand anywhere, you know, just be, just let us know. We're just a call away and we are all with you. Trust me. We understand what has happened.
Thank you.
And we know what you've been through, and a big warm bear hug for you.
This is a victory. This is a victory. This is Jia's victory. You understand me?
Ji.
And this is what Ji. I wanted to bring the truth out.
So absolutely, ma'am.
Sach ko bas shine karana tha na.
Bas.
Aur to koi badle ki to ladai hai nahi.
Nahi ma'am, bas agar cheeze time pe ho jati
to badla us creator ka.
जी, अगर सही चीजें सही तरीके से होती तो शायद आज सुशांत यही होता, दिशा यही होती. जैसे आपने बोला, जिया वाज वन ऑफ द फर्स्ट वंस टू सफर.
यस,
तो अब उसका तो क्या ही कर सकते हैं मैम. लेकिन ठीक है, देर आए दुरुस्त आए, हमें समझ सब आ गया है अब, इतना तो जरूर है. सो वी आर विथ यू.
एग्जैक्टली. यस, थैंक यू. थैंक यू सुधी.
थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू जी. थैंक यू सो मच अब्दुल खान. हाँ ध्रुवा जी, अभी कौन आएंगे हमारे नेक्स्ट पैनल में?
अभी प्रियंका जी है लाइन पर. प्रियंका जी, प्लीज गो अहेड विद योर क्वेश्चन.
हेलो, कैन यू ध्रुवा जी, कैन यू हियर मी?
हां,
यस प्रियंका जी,
लाउड एंड क्लियर.
वी कैन, या वी कैन हियर
यू. थैंक यू मैम. नमस्ते एवरीवन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, अ बिग सैल्यूट टू यू राबिया जी. You are actually a woman and a mother who is standing tall and fighting from so many years. You are an example for other people also, because I have seen ke बहुत सारी जगह तो पेरेंट्स ही सपोर्ट नहीं करते हैं बच्चे के जस्टिस के लिए. वेमेन आर फाइटिंग अलोन. आई हैव सीन इट सेवरल टाइम्स. लाइक आई ऑल्सो सपोर्ट सच गर्ल्स एंड लेडीज. उनकी अपनी फैमिली उनको सपोर्ट नहीं करती है और आप अनकंडीशनली अपनी डॉटर के लिए लड़ रहे हैं. आप सुशांत, आप खुद इतने प्रॉब्लम में है लेकिन आप सुशांत के लिए भी आवाज उठा रहे हैं. एंड देन टू दीप्ति जी ऑल्सो, जो इतना सब कुछ बियर करने के बाद भी सुशांत के लिए भी आवाज उठा रही हैं. तो मैं आप लोगों को सैल्यूट करना चाहती हूँ. आप लोग सोसाइटी के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा एग्जाम्पल हैं. मैम मेरा एक क्वेश्चन है. आई विल नॉट प्रेशराइज यू कि आप अगर नहीं बोल पा रही हैं तो मत बताइएगा. क्या जब आपने ये अपना आवाज उठाना शुरू किया था तो आपकी फैमिली में आपकी जो डॉटर हैं जो और जो दूसरे फैमिली मेंबर्स हैं, क्या उनको थ्रेटनिंग्स मिली और उनको कोई और लॉस भी उठाना पड़ा है? जैसे मैम आई कंप्लेंट अबाउट अ वेरी पावरफुल पर्सन इन माय लोकेलिटी, तो मुझे उसने मेरे कंपनी में कॉल कर दिया और मुझे जॉब से भी निकाल दिया गया. सो आई हैड बिग फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स. तो क्या आपको इनडायरेक्टली भी इस तरह की कि मतलब कहीं पे कुछ भी स्ट्रेटजी बना के और आपको कुछ और नुकसान किया गया, क्या ऐसा आप लोगों के साथ हुआ है?
देखिए जहां तक हमारी बेटी, यस मेरे पास बहुत बेटियां हैं लेकिन हमारी बेटी को जिस तरह मारा उससे बड़ा नुकसान हो सकता है. आई डोंट काउंट राइट wealth as above my children. I don't count wealth above my children. They are the wealth.
Right.
And rahi baat threatening ki, they have threatened. They were thinking that I am doing this. Oh, I am taking the, I am fighting because I will achieve some monetary gain from them. Who wants that money? If the authorities want, right. Good luck to them.
So because such people,
you know, this is the biggest loss. This is the biggest loss. Isse aage aur kya ho sakta hai?
Right.
And they can be destroyed, na? They can't create.
Right. Means जैसे you know, they try to corner you from all the sides. कहीं पे किसी को inform करना, फिर उनसे उल्टे सीधे threatenings दिलवाना, कोई भी इल्जाम लगा के, you know,
they were capable to manage the court, and that is the way they were trying to humiliate me. You understand me? कि ये आती है कोर्ट में.
राइट right.
हाँ मैं आ जाती हूँ लड़ने. right. आती मैं अपना पैसा खर्च करके आती हूँ, फिर भी कोर्ट सुनती है मुझे और डिसीशन आप मैंने उस इन्फ्लुएंस कर दें या मैनिपुलेट कर दें या मैनेज कर दें कोर्ट को, वो बात अलग है.
राइट
right. तो इसी तरह वो कर रहे हैं. मुझे मार के क्या करेंगे वो लोग? एक क्राउन पहन लेंगे. मरना तो उनको भी है ना एक दिन, सभी मरना है.
फ्रीज भाई प्लीज गो अहेड विद योर क्वेश्चन.
हेलो मैम, गुड इवनिंग. Thank you so much for.
Are there too many people?
Forward.
No, just one. No, just one more, ma'am. Just one more, last one.
Okay.
Ma'am, the videos all of us keep on seeing again and again, over again, the CCTV footage that I'm talking about. If you can be a little clear and tell us, ma'am, that the CCTV footage in which Mr. Aditya is been seen, on top of that, the timing that is showing is 11:36. I mean, that's the video that we have. Did you reach there before that, ma'am, or after that? That's one thing I want to know.
You see, the video was taken by the police that very night, and then it was given after 10 days to the society, and we took it from the society. It is not the police who has put the video on their charge sheet. The video was released by us to the media.
Okay. No, because
after receiving it from the police.
Okay, because myself and Himaji,
so the timings could be manipulated.
Okay, that's exactly what I wanted to ask, ma'am. That's exactly what I wanted to ask. And there is some footages which is there in the public domain, and there are some footages which is very strangely only with the BBC, like even Anju Mendru when she's coming inside, ma'am. वो और किधर है ही नहीं वो सिर्फ बीबीसी के इसमें दिखता है सो आई एम 100% श्योर दैट यू हैव ऑल द वीडियोस विद द राइटेस्ट टाइम क्लिकिंग ऑन टॉप एंड दैट विल सेल्फ विल मेक इट वेरी क्लियर व्हाट टाइम दैट मैन हैड कम इन एंड व्हाट टाइम ही
वाज नो सॉरी आई डोंट हैव व्हाटएवर दे हैव शोड एंड व्हाटएवर यू आर सीइंग इज द वीडियो दैट वाज गिवन टू the society by the police after 10-12 days.
तो आपके हिसाब से उन्होंने कार्ड फिट के चेंजेस वेंजेस मैनिपुलेट उन्होंने करके फिर से रिटर्न सोसाइटी को दिया है.
Yes, yes, okay. yes.
Okay, okay.
I don't have any. That is the original and that is what it is.
ठीक है, because BBC के पास एक extra थोड़े बहुत footages है.
What it was before, it would be with the police
with the not police with only. Me theek hai but the society ko jo diya gaya wo aapke paas aa gaya fir baad mein
nahi wo to fir humne society se
manga barabar to wo aapne yes. jab hi uska yes. timings aur wo sab aapke hisab se abhi jab hi check kiya to usme aapko 100% changes and manipulative lag rahe hain because wo video sab ek straight line mein bhi nahi hai cut cut ke hai wo edits usme clear dikh rahe hain ha
वो वीडियो वो तो कट कट के लगाया है बट अगर आप एक सेट में देखेंगे वीडियो को तो उस वक्त हमको नहीं मालूम था कि ये राइट टाइम है कि गलत टाइम है हम तो देख रहे हमको टाइमिंग्स का कब पता चला जब हमको कॉल लॉग्स मिला तो कॉल लॉग से जब आप टाइमिंग वीडियो के साथ में मैच करते हैं तो वो मैच नहीं होता
मैं यही जानना चाहता था मैम ठीक है दूसरी बात एक दूसरे बंदे ने काफी इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो बनाए थे उस पे सो आपका जो आप फर्स्ट फ्लोर पे थे मैम उस टाइम फर्स्ट फ्लोर का घर है आपके फर्स्ट फ्लोर के बाहर के तरफ का जो एक गैलरी या तो विंडो है उस पे क्या पहले से ग्रिल था कि वो ओपन था मैम
ग्रिल नहीं था
थैंक यू वेरी मच दैट्स दिस टू थिंग्स आई वांटेड नो Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, and in my personal capacity, we'll keep fighting for you, ma'am. Thank you very much. We love you. Thank you.
Inshallah. That's it?
Yeah, ma'am. That for now, for very much for now, that's it. Because one more person was supposed to join. I'm not sure. So that person did not join. So Deepti ji, you're on mute. Any closing comments? Deepti ji?
No, Rabia ji. Rabia ji, thank you so much for your time and thank you so much for coming and keeping things in the right perspective, everything out in the, for the public to be aware of. And we are so very appreciative and, impressed by your flight, relentless flight for your daughter. Hats off to you. You are an inspiration, actually. Okay, so I too and we all here are here because we want truth to win.
Look, I have done the maximum investigation and given to CBI. What I want that you people should really bring out Sushant's case and ask right questions and get, because the officers will not investigate. Our case, we had to investigate. All those reports, forensic reports and everything should be collected and should be analyzed by other experts.
Yes, sure.
To do that.
Sure. We have to ensure that Priyanka ji, Amrika ji, Dhruva ji, thank you so much for keeping this movement alive. Hum log aise as a public, what we can do, we are doing. We are getting together. हम लोग आवाज उठा रहे हैं. That's the reason it went to CBI in the first place. Otherwise, उसको भी suicide करके brush aside कर देते इस क्रेज को. It's the public. Yeah. It's the public जो pressure बनाए रखा है. And now the public is becoming aware of what exactly happened in Jia Khan's case as well. Thank you, ma'am, yeah. for enlightening them. And yes, अभी ये movement बनने लगा है. We have had to sacrifice Jia Khan. We have had to had sacrifice Sridevi ji. We have had to had sacrifice Sushant Singh Rajput and many others like them. But now people are becoming aware, and I am sure that the moment of awakening is not far. And we will get justice.
Good.
For
keep on doing. Jia Khan.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank
ma'am,
you,
ma'am. Just one Thank word. Last word. We love you. Keep guiding us. You have had experience with the agencies. Tell us what we can do in the best way so that our case gets stronger. We are doing as much as possible, keeping the pressure on. We are investigating as much as possible on our own. But we'd love to hear whenever you could find time and guide us would be wonderful, ma'am. And we are always there for you. Thank you. Thank you.
And my lots of empathy to you and your family. And, you know, just keep praying and yeah, let's get on.
Absolutely, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Dipti.
Thank you.
Bye, Dipti.
Thank you, Dipti, for giving me all the information. And let's pray for Sushant and his soul for doing such wonders, for doing, you know, bringing awareness in public, that open your eyes and see where you are, what your environment is, where you're getting on. If you will not correct it today, then you will be doomed.
Exactly. If not,
it's our children, it will be your children. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
It's a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call. Okay. Thank
exactly.
you.
Exactly. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. So much, Ravi.
And
thank
Rabia
you,
ma'am.
Everyone. Thank you. Thank
Rabia
you,
Rabia ma'am. Now the stream is ending.
Yes.
I'll tell you why this was a special yes. gift for me, you coming on the stream today. Today happens to be my birthday as well. Thank you, everyone in the chat sections. Those who wish me a very happy birthday. Oh. It means a lot. Thank you.
Many happy returns. Many happy returns to you. Many happy returns to you. God
thank
bless you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. We will always be there with you in this fight. We'll always be there with you in this fight.
We are always here, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay.
And one message for you, Dipti ji. I want to say that don't stop. Don't stop. We are with you. There will be good people, there will be some criticism also, and there will be lot and lot of negative people also. Don't stop. And for Rabia ji, I want to say that I'm going to run few on-road campaigns also for Jia for sure. Even if I'll be alone, I will go. I will go in front of CBI office also and some other officers as well. But my request is don't stop. We all are with you.
Sure, okay. Priyanka ji. Sure. Thank you so much. Aap aise hi lage rahiye. Hum bhi aise hi lage rahenge.
Okay. Priyanka ji, aap bhagne wale ho ki campaign ko bhagane wale ho?
Main to kahin nahi bhagungi.
ध्रुव जी हैप्पी बर्थडे आप भी मत भागो हम सब इधर ही रह के फाइट करेंगे कोई भागेगा नहीं एंड थैंक यू दीप्ति जी आई विल टेक एवरीवनस लीव थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक्स
फॉर द अपॉर्चुनिटी
थैंक यू रेखा
थैंक यू
एंड आई वुड लाइक टू एंड दिस शो विद वेरी 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 बेस्ट विशेस टू ध्रुव जी ऑन हिज बर्थडे हैप्पी बर्थडे ध्रुव जी आई होप
मैं भगवान नहीं हूं यार हाथ जोड़ के मत बोलो हाथ खोल के बोलो आराम से
okay bye take care good day
take care.
Bye thank you so much thank you everyone.
Okay on that note the session was an outstanding one the highest of highest positivity thank you so much guys for the birthday wishes with all due respects to each one of you let me tell you one thing we will definitely try and get Rabia ma'am for another show and at that time we will let yeah Vishrut ji I have already thanked you so many times off the record on record I'll tell you one thing thank you so much sir salute to you for wishing me on the birthday And yes, so on that note, with the highest level of positivity, thank you so much for tuning in, guys. It was one of a session today. And yeah, criticism or the society today, it is us. We need to fight it strong and we need to take the movement to the next level. Thank you, one and all. Thank you for tuning in today. Have a great day. Bye-bye.